Hello, this is Claudia Mendoza. I'm the teacher director of the Joy of Learning Academy. I've been running my program for 24 years, and today I'm making this video for childcare providers who have a business at home like me, and I want to share my parent handbook. A parent handbook is a very important tool that all the carers must have. This is a way for you to communicate with your families about your program. This is a reference guide for your parents, for them to know about your policies, your regulations. The parent handbook should answer all parents' questions about your program. It is kind of like a contract, and replace a contract, daycare contract, an agreement with important information. We could go over in another video. Here are the licensing requirements. I have extra forms like permission for transportation, some photo release, and more. So I could share with you in another video. But today I wanna focus on the parent handbook. So before we begin, I would like to thank all of you who took the time to subscribe to our new channel. And if you didn't yet, please subscribe so we could continue making videos that may be helpful to you. Here I have for you different styles of parent handbooks I made over the years. The first one was more like a brochure. I made this in 1996 when we opened, and it had the information of the school, our license number, and then, address where our location was. And inside I had a letter for parents when I explained the quality of our program, that we were licensed and what does licensing means, what they may expect from us, which was our program, experience, professionalism, safe environment, caring, and what do we expect from parents, like we expect from them to pick up the child on time, not to bring them when they were sick, fulfilling the financial arrangements, not bringing, you know, toys to school, and parent participation as well. And then in the back I have their our daily routine at that time, and the hours of operation, and the meals that we serve. So this is just something simple with a lot of information, just an idea if you wanna make it a brochure style. In 2000, I had to add more pages, so I made it like a booklet, and then I started running the earlier preschool program in 2005, so I had more policies and guidelines. So it's important to update it every year. So let's go over the most updated one for this video. You want to add in the cover page the name of your school. Don't forget to put your license. And I have to update every year. So here is the school year that this one applies. You know, my email address, the address of the school. And here's my table of content. And inside I have the letter of for our parents, mission statement, our philosophy, our daycare history, curriculum, education, our preschool program, parent participation, child's eligibility, preschool program fees, our preschool daily routine, illness policy, COVID-19, inclusion and exclusion guidelines, persons authorized to pick up, meals, guidance and discipline. Now I'm gonna show you what I have in each section so it may give you ideas to whatever applies to your program. In our first page, we have our parent letters. Here is where I welcome our students, our new families to our program and let them know that it is a privilege for us that they choose our program for their education and care of their child. That teaching and caring for children is my profession by choice, and I've been doing this for, you know, 25 years. So it gives them an overview so you can make a letter how you want it. I have here the mission of our program. Our mission is to plant a seed for tomorrow's greatness by enriching children's lives emotionally, socially, mentally, and physically, engaging parents and the community for the best interests of a child. I put here the philosophy, and you could put what is your philosophy. We have a very strong child development philosophy, where we believe that every child is unique and that he or she learns at his or her own pace, and children's best through play, and experiences, modeling, repetition, we believe that parents and teachers and community could make a difference in a child's life. And therefore, we, as facilitators and partners to the families we serve, we will provide quality interactions, we provide stimulating activities, meaningful experiences as a means of creating and nurture a lifelong love of learning, because we want to raise eager learners. Then we talk about the history of the program, so you may tell them, you know, when you open, whatever information you want to share. In here, because, you know, we've been open for 25 years, I started in my parents' house, so we opened in 1996, with the purpose to help families who needed reliable childcare. At that time, my major was business management, and after getting my degree and observing children enrolling in our program, growing from small babies to active toddlers, we spanned our program, including many stimulating activities. So I began to take child development classes. That's when I realized that this is what I want to do, make a difference in a child's life. So I got my AA in child development, also my teacher permit and site supervisor permit. So we also became accredited in 2001. Then I got married and became a mother myself. So we purchased our own home and moved our daycare twice. And then we decided to build our home from scratch. So I became part of the LAR program in 2005. Also became a mentor in the same year, part of the QSLA. So this is where you want to take the opportunity to highlight about your program. Here is our curriculum. Our curriculum, like I mentioned, we have a very strong child development base where kids learn through play, and we incorporate the essential factors of the California Preschool Learning Foundation. Also, we use creative curriculum, that is a research-based curriculum, and we include our kids' interest. Here in the education part is where I mentioned that I hold a child development site supervisor permit, a master teacher permit, and if you have any child development units, this is where you want to add them. If you don't, I'm sure that you attend workshops at your CPR, any professional grow hours, you want to add them here, because this is going to show your parents your commitment in the field. Then I have the information of my assistant. And in the professional area is where you want to add any organization or program that you're part of. Like here I put that I'm part of Child 360, any memberships that you have. I have the NAFCC. Also, I had to add that I'm part of QSLA, who raised the quality of our program. It is our years of experience in preschool, as a mentor, as a daycare provider, 25 years. And these are all our achievements. I was the teacher of the year back in 2009. So here is some information of our achievements in the field. Things that you were part of and you wanna write it down. Here is our preschool program. Like I mentioned, I provide mainly preschool, 3 hours a day, Monday through Friday. So here is the information about our program. Like I mentioned, you could copy and get the ideas of what applies to you. And if you offer daycare all day, you wanna write your schedule, your hours of operation and information. And here is the parent participation. You know, parents help us filling out the ages and stages. And we also have a parent conference twice a year. We share the results of the DRDPs. We do DRDPs in our class, and we also use other assessments to help monitor the milestones of our students, and also to help us where they need assistance and become competent. Next, I have the information for child's eligibility. These are the documents that I need extra besides the licensing forms. We need immunization records, birth certificate, physician report. I know some family daycares don't require the physician report, but I'm part of the QSLA. I have extra forms besides licensing forms. In our preschool program fees, it says here to see the schedule for tuition and fees. We offer flexible schedules, so parents could choose to bring their kids 5 days a week, 4 days a week, 3 days a week. We charge a non-refundable enrollment fee of $100 June or July. they only pay half, 50%, so which is only $50. Then the cost of the t-shirt. We have an early drop and late pickups every 10 minutes before and after preschool. So for example, if departure is at 12, they have 10 minutes of grace period, but after the 10 minutes, we start charging $5 every 10 minutes. Same if a school supposedly starts at 8 or 9, if they come 10 minutes early, there's no charge, but before those 10 minutes, yes, we do have a $5 fee. If parents have an emergency or they need daycare for extra time, they could always let us know in advance and then pay just the hourly fee. But if they don't give us any notice in advance, then they have to pay the late fee. Here is our preschool routine. So you may put the routine of your program. So here is our illness policies, and it is required that a parent will not bring his or her child if he or she has temperature or any contagious illness. Children with mild, ill, or conditions that do not require exclusion will be accepted for care. Children who become ill with excluded symptoms will be cared away from others until the child is picked up. A special care plan will follow, and here we have here to see the inclusion and exclusion guidelines. Even before COVID-19, we use these care inclusions. This one is for non-diagnosed illness, and here are the ones that are diagnosed by the physician that you want to follow. And we got these guidelines at the Childcare at its Best, giving children a healthy start. The purpose of having illness policies are to ensure every child receives a healthy, safe, and supportive experience, to protect the health of everyone in the group, to assist in meeting all children's needs, to protect the rights of each child and family. Parents will support your illness policies when you have them in place because they want to have a safe environment for their child. So I'm very pleased that all these years, parents help us by keeping their child at home when their child is sick. We got our new COVID policies and guidelines, and we had to follow strict guidelines and procedures for everyone's safety. So at this time, I'm just going to go over a few. We are not accepting children with fever, cough, hoarse, runny nose, and vomiting, no exceptions. Now, if a child has been out of the country, needs to wait 2 weeks before attending and with a negative test in order to participate. Parents need to report immediately if a child was exposed to a relative or someone diagnosed with COVID-19 for the safety and the safety of other children, and child needs to be in quarantine. Although we have many large areas in our program that are shade, and we offer an outdoor program at this time to even make it more safe, we asking parents to apply sunblock before coming to our program. And we're asking parents to keep unnecessary items from home because we have to disinfect everything that comes in. Our program is providing a clear face shell. And children 2 years are not required to wear a mask. And we don't have children under 2, but children 3, they have to wear a mask. I'm just gonna go over care and inclusion guidelines and give you samples of few. But here are the signs, the symptoms, as a caregiver, what we're gonna do, and what needs to happen in order for a child to return, and if a doctor note is required. So for example, runny eyes. If we see watering eyes, we're gonna observe, and there is no action taken. And if it has a little bit of yellow discharge, we clean them from the outside, if it's outside, and there is a yellow or green charge discharge reappears, then we're going to exclude them, and the child could come back after it's treated for 24 hours. And if doctor note is required, yes. We have here, you know, runny nose or throat, stiffy neck, rashes, loose watery bowel movement. These are for non-diagnosed illness. So in here I have for illness diagnosed by a physician and how much time they had to be excluded. So just giving an example, chicken pox here, if it needs to be excluded, yes, they need to be, a child needs to be excluded, and how long, you know, before they return, the waiting period for 6 days and after the first pox appears. And does he need the doctor's note? Yes or no? And here it says no. So rights make a final decision to exclude a child from care. So here is our answering medication, because we only provide a 3-hour preschool program. We are not administering any medication. For emergencies, our program will notify parents promptly in case of an illness, of an accident of the child, and parents are responsible for keeping their updated phone number or if they change address. Okay, we're close to be done. And I know this video is getting long, but I'm trying to give you all the details so it could be easier for you when you're making your own parent handbook. The next part is person authorized to pick up a child. This is where I let parents know that they have to sign in and out on a daily basis in the sheet provided with the date and time and full signature. Also, I let them know that we will not release any child from our facility to anyone who's not in the authorized list. As for the safety of our students, we ask the authorized person to provide a picture ID the first time. Okay, as for the meals, our program cares about the health and growth of each child. So we participate in the food program and we partially get reimbursed for the cost of nutritious meals. For all these years that we've been in serving our community, we provide nutritious hot lunches. It's homemade meals that includes fresh fruit, vegetables, lean meats. Teaching by modeling manners, healthy and habits and acceptance are values that we teach and we reinforce daily. And we ask parents not to bring any gum or excessive amount of sweet. And parents are welcome to bring a birthday cake or treat in the child's birthday. And they had to let us know in advance so we could plan the special date. And we ask them to bring food from the store. So our program respects the diversity in religion and take a non-denominational approach to saying grace before lunch. We sing and say grace and we have a chant. This also tells our students that playing time is over, that it's time for us to sit on the table where we eat in a family style, and it's time for them to use their good manners. Freedom of religion is based on individual beliefs, and this is one of the greatest gifts that we have here living in America. And our home has Christian beliefs and faith values of virtues of honesty, compassion, generosity, kindness, faithfulness, respect, and trust. We want to encourage the importance of being a good person has no affiliation to church. We encourage families to familiarize the children with their own beliefs, customs, and ceremonies. Guidance and discipline. This is a very important area because parents always want to know what is going to be your approach when it comes to helping them discipline. You know, when a child misbehaves or when a child hits another child. So our program makes sure that our guidance and discipline, that we make our children feel love, that we want to help them learn, grow, and keep them from hurting themselves. We use incidents and conflicts as teachable moments for them to learn about their feelings and model appropriate behavior. We guide them and practice social acceptable ways for them to respond. So we acknowledge each of their feelings, and because social emotional is a big part of this age for them to build their character and learn acceptable ways for them to respond. So our quality teacher interactions are very important to make sure that we want them to be happy, responsible, and caring individual. We encourage and praise them good behavior so that way their positive behavior could continue. And our daily routine is designed to assist children to know what to expect so that way avoids misbehavior. Our activities are planned and we give children choices, and they know what's going to happen, and transitions are less stressful. For examples of some ways that we use is like fixed tabs and redirections. In your example, when a child hurts someone, we ask the child to listen to their feelings. We encourage children to use their words and express their feelings. We ask the child who hurt assist in a process of calming and taking care of the victim. A child who breaks a toy, we ask the child to assist us in fixing. For redirection, when children use things improperly, we stop them, we explain them why we're stopping them, and we encourage them to pick up, suggesting another area for them to go. And we will not permit children to use profane or inappropriate language. And the joy of learning keeps the right to terminate service to a parent when we are not able to meet their child needs. And we also keep the right to make any changes to our policies as needs for the safety of our children, giving them advance notice and changes. To save you time, we're selling our parent handbook. And if you're interested, check in the description below how you could obtain it in a Word format. So you can just change the name of your school, change the information that doesn't apply to you, and add the information that you want in your parent handbook. This will save you a lot of hours. And we are selling at a very low cost because making a parent handbook does take a lot of time. I recently made one, pretty much editing from my, and just editing took me about 10 hours. When I made my parent handbook, it did take me weeks. Getting all the information, entering in the computer, does take time. So I'm trying to facilitate this for you. So I hope that all the information that I provide to you with all the details can help you craft your own parent handbook. And if you already have one, give you ideas for whenever you edit or update your parent handbook. Also, if you don't wanna be dealing with changing information and you need more assistance, we could make a parent handbook for you. We could craft it and customize to your program and give you the hard copy and the file so you could make as many copies as you want. If you would like us to translate parent handbook in Spanish, we could also do that as well. If you already have a parent handbook and you just want a translation in Spanish, we could do that service to you. This will save you time so you could be focused on taking care of your business, taking care of your children. So now you have all the tools for you to make yours. If you want to save time, you could purchase ours at a very low cost. And if you want us to make yours, we could do that and do that service for you. Before I say goodbye, let me remind you that to please subscribe to our channel so we could continue making videos for you and your program could continue to grow. Goodbye.